support be, if support be settles down by 120 by N, same will be there. 120 by N. So same loading will be there. Either we can give loading or they just may ask only this much. Either one can do it. If they don't give any loading, only settlement if they go and give. So due to that settlement, find out the fixed end moment, and for that fixed end moment, carry out the distribution. So as you hear, the first step, you have to find out the end moments at each member, and that this is, you have to determine, always taken in the positive direction. This is what you have to determine, member end forces and the displacements which are there in the joints are only rotations here and here, as I told you in the previous example. So it is only these two rotations. It is not undergoing any translation. So it is non-sway. That is what we have to conclude in the first step. Sway or non-sway, and what is that we have to determine? Member end forces. So then second step, rotation factor, that you are doing only for the continuous joint, other than fixed joints, I'll say. Rotation factor will determine other than joints which undergo rotation. So fixed joints will not undergo any rotation. So at that joint, except those fixed joints, you have to determine rotation factor at all joints. So rotation factor at joints when only one member is there, you can take rotation factor as minus half. Other joints where more than one member is there, that they are called continuing joints, they may have to do the calculation. That is, joint you can take, then members, that is BA, BC as usual, then relative stiffness, I by 4, here 3/4 of I by 3, that is also I by 4, total stiffness, I by 2, then rotation factor is K divided by sigma K into minus half, that is minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4. So at C, it is only one member minus half. Then you have to prepare that diagram I told you in the Kanis method. So fixed joint, you are retaining as it is. Continuous and any other type of joint, you are indicating by two rectangles, one inscribed in the other with four compartments, wherein you will write all the values computed in the first step. That is, rotation factor for BA, we see minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4, that you will write as it is without any change. Then you have to write 5 fixed end moment. That I will determine for this fixed end moment. Here I have taken both member load as well as load due to settlement, whatever load which comes due to settlement. So due to member load, so settlement I will take first for AB. This A to B, it has settled down by 120 by here. Settled down means there must be forces like this. So this is in equilibrium. To keep it in equilibrium, there must be moments developed in this direction, in the anti-clockwise direction. So this has to be negative as per our sign convention. These moments develop, I told you, it will be minus 6 A delta by L square. This force will be 12 A delta by L cube. This will be 6 A delta by L square. That you have to remember. Translation, rotation 4 A by L, 2 A by L. If it is hinge up, forward and is hinge center supported, it is just 3 A by L. That's all you have to remember. So here it is 6 into EI itself, delta is 120 by EI, L square is 6 EI by L square, 6 EI delta by L square is 16. So this value will be 45 minus 45. Similarly, at other member BC, again you assume them to be fixed. So this has settled down by same 120 by EI. So there must be a force like this. Here the force will be in the opposite direction to keep it in equilibrium. But the moment due to this will be in the clockwise direction here. Find it here. Here it is anti-clockwise. Here it is clockwise. So this moment also, 6 here delta by L square, that is 45. It is plus 45. Here it is minus 45. This moment, you have to write it there at the ends of each member. At the member AB, fixed end moment will be fixed end moment due to load. If load is also given, you can take it. If load is not given, only this, you take MAB as minus 45 only. Otherwise, that minus 45 plus minus 80. Means 80 was the moment you got to do this. That minus 80, minus 45, it will be minus 125. So MAB bar equals minus MPA bar, which is equal to minus 80 minus 45. It is.
So MBA will
change. MAB is minus 80 plus minus 45, it is minus 125, and MBA here it is change. It is plus 80, here it is minus 45, so that will be 35. That you have to take. Then MBC bar, it will be minus 20 due to that load.
Plus 45.
Square by L square. Due to this, plus it is 45. Plus 45. 45. So it is 25. Plus 25. Then MCB bar, it will be 40 plus 45. That will be 85. This is the only change with respect to previous problem when there is settlement of supporting system. Due to that settlement, you have to find the fixed end moment that you take it. And that you have to write it. Here it is minus 125, here it is 25, here it is 25 instead of 20, here it is 85. Now this total moment at each joint, that also will change. So here 35 plus 25, it is 60. Here it is 85. Now you have to carry out the Kani's moment distribution in the same fashion. You will get the moment at the ends. So I will just indicate cycle 1. So at A, no rotation. At B only, sum of fixed end moment 60. Rotation contribution at further end, it is 0, 0 to start with. It is 60 only. That 60 multiplied by minus 1 by 4, minus 15 by 4, that is minus 15.
Minus
15. Then at joint C, it is 85
minus 15.
Minus 15, that is equal to
17.
7. 60, yeah?
70
into minus half, it is?
Minus 35.
35. So the cycle 1 is over. Then cycle 2, at A, nothing, at B, now you will get 60,
minus
then further 30. At 0, there it is minus
35,
this is
25.
This sum, you have to multiply it, which coming to join B, shared by the two members in proportion to this, that is minus
6.25
or 6.3, I will make it 6.3. Then at join C, it is 85
minus 6.3.
6.3. 85 minus 6.3.
78.7.
78.7 divided by 2, that is minus 39.4. Like that, you can continue until two consecutive cycles will give the same moment. Where you can stop your work, take whatever that last value is there, that is rotation contribution. Then find MAB is equal to this fixed end moment, twice rotation contribution at that end, near end, rotation contribution at further end. Similarly, MBA is fixed end moment, twice rotation contribution, whatever you got here, then contribution from further end. Like that, MBC, MC. You make sure that MBA plus MBC is equal, MBA equals my, plus MBC is my zero, and MCB is also zero. Then you check. Then, if at all you are not getting, revise the calculations once. So this is about Kani's recommended solution of analysis of beams with settlement also usual. There can be overhang also. Overhang means due to the overhang, whatever membrane moment is there, let you take it. That membrane moment you have to add it to this, whatever is coming, and carry out the same procedure. So whether it is settlement, regular problem, or this, you can work out by Kani's moment distribution. Next, we can take up a frame problem. That is, do we have time?